Enggartiasto, Lukita, Honorable Minister of Trade, Indonesia, to address the inaugural plenary.
His Excellency, Mr. Sri Suresh Prabhu, Minister of Commerce and Industry of India, Honorable Ministers, Indian and ASEAN Business Delegations, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, happy belated New Year, still in January, and a very good afternoon to all of us. This year is a special year. The world economy is estimated to grow at 3.1% after a much stronger than expected 2017, as the recovery in investment, manufacturing, and trade continue. In 2018, advanced economies are expected to grow at 2.2%, while emerging and developing economies will grow much faster at 4.5% as activities in commodity exports continue to recover amidst firming prices. 2018 is even very special for ASEAN and India, as last year we celebrated our 25th anniversary of ASEAN-India relations and the 15th summit, and this year we are entering the first year of another flourishing decades to go. Over these past 25 years, we have grown together. On trade, over these past 25 years, trade with ASEAN constitutes 10% of India's total trade with the world, which places ASEAN as India's fourth largest trading partner. The available statistics for 2015 suggest that bilateral trade between India and ASEAN was recorded at $76 billion. Total trade then declined to $65 billion in 2016. But this is attributed to falling commodity prices and the slowdown of the global economy. On investment, FDI from India contributes to about 3.5% of total investment into ASEAN, while FDI from ASEAN contributes to 17% of total investments into India, both in a 2000 to 2017 time frame. The strong economic relations between us are supported by a formal tie of the ASEAN-India Free Trade Agreement, or IFTA, which has been in effect since 2010. Nevertheless, we learned that AIFTA generated intense debates on its likely fallout on India's economy, particularly on certain agricultural subsectors on which the livelihoods of large number of people are dependent upon. To be candid, not only in India, similar debates also occurred in most of ASEAN countries with regard to the impact of ASEAN plus one FTAs with China, India, Korea, Japan, and Australia and New Zealand. But we cannot see an FTA just from the perspective of the value of exports and imports and how it affects our balance of trade. Let me highlight two things here. First, India may claim that the value of exports from India to ASEAN is not as much as the value of ASEAN's exports to India. India's export to ASEAN recorded at only $26 billion in 2016, while India's imports from ASEAN recorded at $38 billion in the same year. But India's export to ASEAN grew at 17% annually from 2001 to 2016, while India's import from ASEAN grew at 14% in the same time span. So, this is a very good news for India. India's export grew at 17% annually, and right after the ASEAN-India FTA entered into force, India's export to ASEAN increased by 50%, climbing from $23 billion in 2010 to $35 billion in 2011. To me, that is very impressive. Second, we should look at an agreement from a broader perspective. We need to consider, for example, how India's imports from ASEAN have contributed to the development of major economic sectors in India. How India's import of coal, mining, and oils from ASEAN have developed India's manufacturing, construction, and transportation sectors. How India's import of palm oils from ASEAN have supported India's food and beverage, cosmetics and household goods sectors, contributing about 40% of supply in grocery stores and traditional markets, and how India's import of parts of telephone from ASEAN have supported the development of India's ICT sector. Of course, we highly value our imports from India, oils and light vessels, and particularly agricultural and fisheries products, such as meat, shrimps, salt, sugar, basmati rice, and spices, of which India has higher comparative advantages than us in producing them. And if you travel to Southeast Asia these days, you can find basmati rice, naan, and curry at every corner. And of course, we do yoga every week, if not every day. That is how we promote mutual trade and investment for shared prosperity. What I try to highlight here is that ASEAN and India's products could be complementary, and a stronger tie in trade and investment will definitely lead to increased opportunities for business from the two sides to expand trade and investment, which eventually creates jobs. Excellency ministers, ladies and gentlemen, trade and investment flows between India and ASEAN have rapidly increased in the last few years. But of course, we all agree that considering our economies of scale, resources, and human capital, there are plenty of rooms for growth, plenty. But how can we stimulate growth of our trade and investment? One platform is our ASEAN-India FTA. We should make the best use of it. We should make the procedures to use it more business friendly. Another platform we are currently working on, which is probably the only super game in town, is the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, or RCEP. What does RCEP mean to us? RCEP is 50% of world's population, 31% of world's GDP, 32% of world's exports, 27% of world's imports, and 28% of world's FDI. And once implemented, the RCEP will allow us to improve our regional production networks through the expansion and deepening of our value chains. Before I conclude my remarks, kindly allow me to quote one of the respected scholars of Jawaharlal Nehru University. "The rise of China has compelled India to put forth its best efforts to engage with ASEAN as a regional grouping. The ASEAN countries have always looked to India for balancing against China, but India has consistently disappointed them. I'm standing with India to prove that such a quote is wrong, very wrong indeed. I believe India will not disappoint ASEAN, at least not this year, especially with my close relation with Minister Suresh Prabhu. Is not only as a minister, but as a family. I believe India will stand side by side with ASEAN to conclude the RCEP this year. I believe India will see ASEAN and other RCEP participating countries as complementary as India's trading and investment partners. And I believe India will put its best efforts to strengthen its relations with ASEAN and other RCEP participating countries, as each of us cannot stand alone in a vacuum." Excellencies, Minister, ladies and gentlemen, let me end by congratulating my good friend, Minister Sri Suresh Prabhu, and colleagues at the Ministry of Trade of India and the Confederation of Indian Industry, and all partners in ensuring the ASEAN-India Business and Investment Meet and Expo this year a success. This event definitely serves as a great opportunity to build stronger and deeper trade and investment collaborations between ASEAN and India. As Prime Minister Modi says, ASEAN is central to India's Act East policy and our ties are a source of balance and harmony in the region. For ASEAN, India is our natural trade and investment partner, and our ties are a source of growth in the region, and India is our true friend indeed. Thank you. Danayafat.